Logan, what did you do?
Charles, the world is not the same as it was. Mutants. They're gone now.
Hi, welcome to What the Flick. Christy, Alonzo, and Matt, we're so good at our jobs. We're doing movies a week early for you. You're welcome, people of YouTube. We're talking about Logan, which is enormously hyped, not unlike Get Out, which we just talked about. Also, Logan, people are interested in it. And Matt, our comic book expert. Well, please
Next
tell
to
us.
Alonzo.
You know a lot, too.
All right, so Logan is the return and most likely final movie from Hugh Jackman as Logan, a.k.a. Wolverine, a.k.a. James Howlett. This one finds Logan few years in the future, about 15, 20 years in the future, you know, he's kind of settled into a job as a limo driver with an Uber-type app. He's broken down a little bit. He's had it rough, you know, ridden hard, put away wet. Things are not so good for Logan anymore. He's living in this world where most of the mutants, in fact, almost all mutants, seems to have been rounded up and probably wiped out, and there seem to be none anymore. And then something comes along that maybe drags him back into his old life of violence. Let's watch a clip.
Where is she?
Beneath the stains.
She's like you.
Of time.
Very much like you.
The feelings disappear.
She needs our help.
You are.
Someone will come along.
Someone has come along.
I am still right here.
So this is, you know, I guess after Deadpool was a hit, it's like, well, let's make these R-rated now.
All right, great decision.
Which actually is, I think, in a lot of ways. I mean, I think that Deadpool got more out of being an R-rated comedy than this does out of being an R-rated drama in terms of the drama aspect. As far as an R-rated action movie, it's totally getting its money's worth.
I mean, like John Wick level.
Yes,
like,
so much head stabbing and you know, Professor X drops F-bombs and stuff, you know.
Yeah. Listen, if getting stabbed in the head is a trigger for you, don't go through.
Yeah, no kidding.
But there's a lot of that.
But it's weird though, seeing a movie that's this bloody with this familiar character in it. It's kind of like when you've been watching a lot of PG-13 horror movies where people get their throats slit and there's like one drop of blood, you know? You're reminded, oh yeah, this is the world of superheroes is like violent and carnage
and
filled.
And especially Wolverine,
and the movies should also be that way. So that's a smart move, I think, in a lot of ways.
It's not gratuitous though. It's totally, as you say, it's totally germane to who this guy is. Germane, drink, a word we like. it is who he is, and it is who he is at this point in his life, especially, given what all he is up against. And so there is this kind of release, like watching him do what he has to do in every situation that presents itself to him makes absolute sense. It's not, I mean, it's over the top, but justifiably so.
Right.
And really well done, too. I'll just say really fast. You know, a problem we often have is when things are edited within an inch of their life, and this, like, James Mangold, who directed this, allows the big action scenes to really play out with long extended takes, and so you feel the visceral nature of the choreography.
Yeah, this is, I think this movie works really well. Now, similar to what we said for Get Out, if you're thinking about going to see this, go see it. Don't watch this review to hope that we reinforce your hopes for this and then get mad because we're talking about story points. If you're gonna go see,
we're gonna talk around as much as we can, but
you go into this and there are some elements of past stories that this takes pieces of. Specifically, there's elements from Old Man Logan, but it's its own story. There's elements of the X-23 story, which is pretty obvious from the trailer, but it's its own story.
I don't know what that is.
And they're different runs in the comic.
you don't have to know what that is either. Yeah,
no,
for the comic nerds that are out there, this works really well. One of the things that it does that I was really impressed with is it really capitalizes on the chemistry between Patrick Stewart and Hugh Jackman.
Definitely.
Very, very, very well. And then the girl that's in this.
Daphne Keene.
Daphne Keene is fantastic. Mm-hmm. And she's this very mostly stoic character. She hardly speaks for a long time. And there's this nearly feral quality to her that fits very, very well. And I love that, you know, there is this sense of bitterness and desperation and kind of hiding out in this film that you see, you know, it's the movie keeps making reference to Shane, which is a little over the, I mean, maybe a little ham-fistedly, but it does tell a similar story. Like, this guy gets dragged back into a life that he doesn't really want to leave and was hoping, doesn't want to live and is hoping to leave behind him. But God, he's still good at it.
Right.
Still good at it. And you can see one of the things that Jackman does really well is you see that he's so tired of that. And he's so almost disappointed in himself that he keeps going back to that. The thing that Claremont wrote in that comic book, in the Wolverine comic book, you know, that Frank Miller drew, you know, he's the best he is at what he does, and what he does isn't very nice. And this movie really takes that on in a way that we haven't seen with Wolverine before. Like, oh right, this is a stone cold killer.
Yeah.
There is some humanity there. And I love that this movie digs into that without softening the character in a way that he's not still Wolverine.
No, it's still very consistent. And you mentioned the Shane through line with this, but the movie that this reminded me of the most while I was watching it was Midnight Special. It is about a guy who has to go on this road trip with a child who is gifted in some way, but there's also torment there. But
I was thinking Stranger Things, but
I've never seen Stranger Things. I will admit that right now. But it feels like, even though it takes place in the near future, it feels like it was made in the 70s. There's a gritty nature to it. And the way it is paced, it really is evocative of like 70s kind of thriller.
I will say, though, I think it does get a little draggy between the action set pieces at times.
It's long.
It's
220, 210.
Something like that, yeah. Which, and again, like if it needed to be that long, fine. But I think that there are times where it's kind of like, you know, it could kind of pick things up. The other thing, and this is a minor point, I know, but
go ahead.
Humor me on this one. This is now the second movie this year that is set in the nearish future, but like at least a good 10 years later, where cell phones haven't changed at all. And think of the cell phone you had 10 years ago versus the one you have now. Like, cell phones change, you know? The cars are different in this movie. They do a few stabs at kind of...
The cars are hardly different.
But different enough. The limo is different.
I mean...
Yeah, okay. So it's a Chrysler 300 with different badges on it. Okay.
Well, the front is... I don't know. There's an effort to do some futurism there. And most of the movie is set, like, out in the middle of nowhere. So, like, yes, of course, an Oklahoma farm is still going to pretty much look the same. That was fine, but it's the cell phones. The cell phones need to look more like smaller or bigger or something. You know, I need some futurism here.
But it also very much embraces like an analog, tactile past, like the place where Patrick Stewart is living.
True.
Yeah. The first time, I'm not going to tell you, but the first time you see it, it is so striking. It's such a beautiful image, the place that they're holed up in the desert. So they want to, I think, embrace a kind of gritty analog past. I know you want fancy see-through cell phones or whatever.
What was the movie we were talking about with only
things in the future was the laptop.
It was the space between us.
Yes.
Same problem.
Yes.
That's the only reason. That's why I noticed it more in this one, because we just went through Space Between Us, which is the same bullshit. I like the fact that we haven't really seen an old superhero in a movie before. I don't think in the current crop of. Film.
Not
so,
like this. Magneto
and Professor X and the X-Men movie.
Right. I mean, in terms of like the fact that his aging is a plot point. Like his claws don't come out all the way sometimes, you know.
Right.
He does not pop the bullets out as easily. His recovery time is slower. You know, he's got gray hair. Like this is a character that we have seen sort of, you know, in full vitality, who we're now seeing as this kind of like, he's still in it, but it takes him a little longer to do the thing. That's an interesting spin that I like.
Right. You know,
Hugh Jackman's really great in this.
He is.
Yeah, I think this is an excellent movie. And you know, as you mentioned in our Get Out review, this is the other movie that is early top 10 list contender.
Yes. Who knew?
I mean, in a February that we've got two movies this good is right before Oscars.
The weekend of the Oscars.
I've heard people say, oh, it's the best Wolverine movie. And I'm like, yeah, but that's damning with faint praise.
Well, James Mangold also did. Movies. Oh. Are we counting those too? I don't know. James Mangold also did the Wolverine from 2013. He also did that.
Right. And again, the action set pieces were much better than the rest of the movie.
Is that when he goes to Japan?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool.
But Mangold also gave us 310 to Yuma.
That was
great.
And
this one, I think, is in that.
Walk the line.
In that area, right? This is a really strong movie. It almost, so close to achieves the emotion it's going for by the end of it.
No.
Almost.
You think it falls short?
I think it's going for tears and doesn't quite get
it. Yeah, no, I mean, I like this movie a lot. I'm not super over the moon about it, right. But I think it's a lot of fun and people should totally see it.
Okay, then what's your number?
I said 7. Okay. I think it is a solid piece of work.
I'm saying 8.5.
Yeah, I'm saying 8.5 too. This movie's great.
Okay, our number is an 8. And where is it?
It's in the 90s on the tomato meter last I checked.
96, maybe? 96. Who dares not like Logan? Coming after you.
Sabretooth.